This is much harder than you think. Hey guys, it's William the Antioxidant Queen, and this is take two, because if I was doing the editing, this would have been finished already. I only have 4 minutes to talk. You might be asking who that was. That was Ozzy the One-Eyed Puggle. He's 16. I got him 10 years ago when he was six. I felt my puppy clock was ticking and everything like that, so I just went to the shelter and I said, I just need a little dog. I don't care how old they are. I don't even care if they know their name. I just don't want them to pee or poop in my house. And they're like, well, come back there and look. I'm like, I ain't going back there because I'll walk out with them all. And they were like, okay, we'll bring you this one. And they brought me Ozzy. And his name stuck, even though all my other ones have Greek gods and goddesses, Egyptians, constellations, Norse gods and everything. But Ozzy just stayed. Ozzy the One-Eyed Puggle. I've got this crap in my head. I might as well do something with it for you. Flavon mask, Neod, keep it on 10 minutes. They said dry face. It has 3 working mechanisms, purifying, detoxing. They don't classify this as a mask in a traditional sense because, A, you lay it on real, real thin. That is the truth. When they tell you this, do it. It does have a scent, a fragrance to it. But it's not overpowering. It actually smells kind of nice. I did pull up on the INSI list some of the things I just want to highlight. Because you know me, I don't go through the whole list. Because A, I can't pronounce half the names. And B, I'm not looking to be a skin influencer or anything like that. These are opinion videos, and that's how I keep them. Some key ingredients I just want to call out to you folks. It has potassium, azelaic, diglycerol. Senate in it. I had to hit the little question button on that one. Ooh, I could feel it like burning. Not burning, but really warming up. And it is tight. And actually, it is dry. And I only got 2 more minutes because this really has to come off. Antioxidant, it's got resveratrol into it. Again, the potassium, nitrate, whatever. That is a derivative of azelaic acid. Who knew? So that's going to give me some anti-acne properties. That's going to give me some skin brightening. And Rob always talks about azelaic acid and it's brightening skin, hyperpigmentation. And I never felt a need for it in there. But, you know, a little help. Soothing. Again, it has the derivative of the azelaic acid. And it also has Alter Ammonis ferment extract. I had to look that up, and it is secreted microorganisms living in hydrated deep vents of chamomile. And this is supposed to protect against UVB damage and what they consider mechanical stressors. And what they meant by that was shaving. So I don't see people putting this onto their body and shaving their legs and stuff like that. So I thought that was a little maybe geared towards men. Just a little bit of buzz and stuff like that that's been going on in my head. I'm going to do 3 more videos throughout the next couple of weeks and everything like that. I do know one I'm definitely wanting to do. I use Dr. Brenner's 20% vitamin C. That's made here in the USA. And like Geek and Gorgeous Seaglow, it's made in batches every 2 weeks, and it's the same price, and it's out of New Jersey. I ordered it on Thursday, and I received it like Monday, and this was several months ago, and I used a whole bottle. It lasted me 6 weeks, did not oxidize, didn't even change color, but we're going to get into that. The second one was the Timeless 20%, and the third one I'm about to use in about a week or so is the Sea Glow. I got that on my Geek and Gorgeous haul and everything like that. My AM PM routines are going to change up a little bit because as I was doing all these Christmas hauls, you know, again, because I like to buy everyone's skincare because everyone knows that I'm into it and they always ask what I'm using and I know their concerns and what they want. And I kind of bought some people some things that I decided to keep. Besides the flannel towels from Face Theory, there's some antioxidants down. Oh, I don't have that particular brand and kind. Oh, I don't have that. So I'm going to incorporate that and maybe do some switch up and maybe pull some into my evening routines. With the Flavon mask, we're going to do a little Christmas experiment, and I'm going to give this credit to Marlene for her Christmas glow. I want to show you guys something. We all know what this is. It just needs a little love. And it has a lot of love on it, because this is a little Christmas ball here. This was my great-grandmother's. My grandparents were, they came from Poland right before Hitler invaded. My great-grandparents were political, and they were considered wealthy, you know, from Poland and everything of that time, and they had wealth. And they got their two daughters and their husbands out of Poland and into America. So on my mother's side, I'm only third generation Polish-American, everything like that. My whole family vanished on my mother's side. The Holocaust happened, and it's Christmas. But back to Marlene and the Christmas glow. This tree is, we all know, the Charlie Brown tree. And just like us, this tree just needs a little love. So I am going to give myself a little love with this. And in part two, we're going to see the effects. I'm going to give my opinion on it and see how it goes. And hopefully, maybe we can get this tree a glow up. I'll talk to you more in a little bit. See you later. Oh, I wanted to play Rudolph again. Oh, how do I do that? Call me names.